Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
Nanki is complex. She's, you know, there are reasons for what she does. When is this interview? Can I give a spoiler? Can I just say it? Because it's like there.
From the prep, and we prep really hard, Ruchi.
Were you cracking the whip? Welcome all of you on Film Companion. So Guilty is a film about consent, and normally, not well, the ones we've seen so far in Hindi cinema, Inkar and Aitraz, are all set in office settings. Ruchi, why is this story on a campus? How did it originate?
Well, the real reason that I put it on a campus is because it's consent is also, it's about mentality. So that is a wider subject of the film. And I thought if you set it in a college, that's where people's formative years are. Of course, you have a certain upbringing with your parents, and then you go out into the real world. And I really feel that college is where your own personality clashes with your upbringing, and you start forming your own ideas. You meet so many people, and that's where you start becoming, you know, a thinking adult. So that's the reason I wanted to set it in a college, because that's the formation of tomorrow's society.
Kiara, you said, I think it was in an interview, you said that consent is a victim of perception.
Yes.
What does that mean?
I feel, you know, the thing is, it's so complicated.
It is. It's very complicated, yeah.
Especially because it's in a campus setup. Sometimes you don't know who to believe, because there are different versions of the story. There are many truths. And what may seem consensual in the beginning to some, the turnover may just throw you off and be like, but I thought you were in this, you wanted it as well. So it then gets very complicated. So that boundary, that line that one crosses is when I feel, you know, where a story, when you're trying to see who's right, who's wrong in that situation. Also, the film tackles with so many different point of views and so many different ways, mindsets, and the way each person sees this situation, that when we were doing the trailer launch, I'm like, how do I put this concisely? And it was actually Karan who gave me this line, so I have to give credit to him. Because I was like, you know, Karan, how do I say it without giving away the story? There's so many spoilers.
Yeah.
You know, because the way the narrative, even though it's such a sensitive topic, what's interesting is and engaging is the way Ruchi's telling you the story. It's from a very different angle than we've ever seen a rape film story situation. And it was interesting because we never really looked at that side of it. There are some cases which are black and white and an open and shut case. This one makes you question a lot of things.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that's why that really made sense to me then when he said that.
But like you said, this is very complicated. It is very tricky. So when all of you were enacting these roles where, from what I've seen of the film, of course, I haven't seen the whole film, but it's hard to figure out what the truth is, you know? So when all of you were doing this, and for you guys, it's your first, sort of what are you mindful of that what could come across perhaps as not what you want it to be? You know, Gurfateh, for you, what was the hardest thing?
I think it was just putting yourself in that situation and not judging yourself, because, I mean, if I am in life doing something or even remotely close to it not being consensual maybe, then I would like obviously steer away from it. So, I had to be mindful of that. I had to be mindful of what is consent and what is not consent. How do people cross the line, because the line is so thin, but there's such a huge gap. Like she said, that it's just perception, right? My consent could be different than hers. I'm sure I have felt uncomfortable in certain positions by the opposite sex, or even the same sex sometimes, and I'm sure so have all of us at given points in time. But it's so subjective, but at the same time, I think just not being judgmental about the character was the toughest bit, and to make it believable also, because you have to completely change your whole wiring of how you've been brought up and what you've been taught, that this is right and this is wrong.
Yeah.
And then being accused of an alleged rape case. That's obviously a tough one.
What about for you?
For me, it was like it was complex initially, because also as a person, I'm very different. So my battle began right there. I'm extremely talkative and jovial in general, and Danish is the equal and opposite of that guy. And I always wanted to play a lawyer. My mom was telling me yesterday after she saw it, hey, you finally got one of your things that you wanted to do. I wanted to be a lawyer.
Bucket list.
Yeah, and I always do. I argue with people. I'm always trying to reason out things. They're like, good. And they have a different language. Ruchi comes from a lawyer's family. So I was talking to Sergeant Narain, and he's fought these big cases. So I realized how difficult it is to be a lawyer, because, again, when we're talking about judgments and guilty, right? Because it's all about how do you keep yourself away and not judge somebody? Because everybody's telling their truth. That's the beautiful thing about who done it or why done it.
Kanika, for you, your character is actually extremely complex, because she comes off as one thing and then she does something else. How did you find your way into her head?
Most definitely, like he said, on my script, the first page clearly was like, do not judge Tanu, because I found myself doing that, obviously.
It was written then?
I wrote it.
You wrote it, okay.
Because of course, because when me and Ruchi would go through readings, I would say, really, but would she?
Yeah.
And I was doing that constantly. And then you come to realize, when you're making a decision in your life, you don't think, I have an ulterior motive. I'm doing this because I'm going to gain this. So why am I thinking that for Tanu? So that was that. I definitely had to be mindful of empathizing with her, because if I didn't, nobody else would. So mentally, that was a big thing for me. And I think even her physicality was very different from what I am and have been. So it was a mix of all of these things to kind of meet Tanu's character halfway to mine. And yeah, that's what I kind of tried to do.
And for you, Kiara?
I feel for me, I think for each of us, the paths are very different from who each one is.
Did you find yourself judging her?
Tanu's character?
No, Nanki.
A lot. No, I didn't find myself judging Nanki's character, because there are a lot of complexities. But what I really needed to do was I needed more exposure, because I've never met anyone who's been in that situation. So I needed to empathize and to really understand the gravity of something like that. Because for us, when we read about a rape case or a rape victim, rape survivor, there's always, we look at it from our point of view, is usually anger, we want justice for them, this and that. But we don't know what really they go through. So I needed to know that. And the minute I met someone who, you know, I mean, it's very courageous to actually talk to someone about what you've been through. And it's such a difficult truth to even just speak up. And that's when I realized, when she told me that, you know, when you, the minute you acknowledge it, and the first person you tell, it took her 2 years to actually tell her best friend that this had happened to her. That's when she said, I didn't say it till then, because I knew that the minute I say it, it becomes so real, and then right. It's a part of, which it is, but the minute I say it, it's something that I cannot erase. And she said, you know, I don't give a shit about the justice. I don't, because whatever happened cannot be changed.
Yeah.
And that really stayed with me so strongly that I just felt like it's such an important subject and such, it's, you know, that we are, that our film is based on. And also it's something which, it's so sensitive and it's so, it's just, you can't even imagine it, but to really play a part in a film, I mean, I don't want to give spoilers, you will see the film and understand why, what is happening. It was really important for me to do that research and get there. And doing that, I felt like I need to do this now with that 100% belief, honesty, integrity with this part. And yes, it is complicated. Nanki is complex. She's, you know, there are reasons for what she does. When is this interview? Can I give a spoiler? Can I just say it? Because it's like there. But okay, not saying it, I think it was a really liberating experience. I would say that.
Ruchi, is there, like she said, this is, you know, it's a very, very important subject. It's complicated. It's serious to tell that in a gripping way. To have three women write this, to have you and Atika Chohan and Kanika Dhillon write this, is there a burden because you're three women writing it, to get it exactly right?
Not at all, according to me, because it's, I mean, as a woman, there are certain things I live through every day, and there are certain things which I get to do and I definitely don't get to do because of that. And these things build up and add to a lot of choices you make, behavior and all. When we were writing, when I discussed the story first with Kanika, and we wrote a draft, the main thing, I mean, I definitely knew the story. The main thing was to make sure that it's engaging and people don't know where it's going till the end.
And they don't know who to believe.
So that is a very craft-oriented thing.
Right, you know,
so that was our main endeavor. And then later, when Atika wrote the dialogues, that time we had much more discussion, which was really fun. Because, you know, we have similar perspectives and it was a lot of actually sharing experiences. And
it comes from lived experiences.
Yeah. And, you know, little things. And what I loved actually about Atika is that whatever little discussion we had now about some random thing, she just found a way to get it in somewhere or the other. So I really enjoyed that process. I mean, I had so much fun working, you know, with both of them, though we never ever sat together in a room. But it was a really fun experience. And actually, I've never worked with women writers on something before. And that was also fairly liberating, because otherwise it is a very serious subject and you talk about things. But I find with when women get together, we find it very easy to go from being extremely serious and also be able to laugh and make light of things and not take things so seriously and then suddenly know the gravity of something. So it was a really fun experience, actually.
And I'm sure the content itself has been shaped very much by the fact that it's a female director and two female writers.
Yeah, meaning it's because at the end of the day, it's an expression of what, you know, like what, say, one wants to share with the world.
Yeah.
So we cannot divorce our gender.
From what you're showing.
Yeah.
Okay, last question. Lots of comparisons to 13 Reasons Why, Riverdale. Oh, what is your response? Is there a little flattered feeling in there?
Yes. Why the flattered?
Yes. We were going for that.
How sweet.
And I really did enjoy watching.
What's the downside?
My response is, I have to go and watch Riverdale.
Yeah,
I've seen one episode of 13 Reasons Why, but I have to finish it now.
That's right. That's right. You have to have an articulate response. Come on. You have to at least see the show, Ruchi.
No, I mean, of course I will see it, but I mean, fortunately, suddenly so much work is happening that one doesn't get time to see anymore.
It's a good problem to have.
Yeah, it's a great problem.
But the rest of you are flattered.
Yes. Why not so sweet?
Yeah.
Super. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.